Wild winds which have battered parts of New South Wales, even bringing down scaffolding on the northern beaches, have continued throughout the night. The SES responded to more than 1,000 jobs across the state in the past 24 hours, more than half of those in Sydney. And let's bring in today's Sydney reporter Jack Hahn now, who is at the airport for us. Jack, strong winds have affected flights there this morning.
Yeah, that's right. That's because a single runway has been used for the last 3 hours or so. But in some news just in, Lizzie, I can tell you that air traffic controllers are hopeful to reopen both runways within the next half an hour or so. That will be welcome relief for travellers taking to the sky this afternoon. I know that Qantas has been reaching out to some passengers saying, look, if you can get on an earlier flight and do that, then you might as well, just to remove any of the stress of worrying about your flight this afternoon. But the news just in, both runways will be reopened here at Sydney Airport as the wind reduces. But spare a thought for these people you're about to meet, the man and the group of girls. They were supposed to leave Sydney on Friday. Their flight was cancelled due to the meltdown. And then their flight yesterday was cancelled due to strong winds. So let's have a look from them now.
Hopefully it won't affect me. Otherwise, I'll be stranded here. My family waiting for me there in Melbourne.
2 days ago.
Wow, so you're still trying to get away?
Yeah.
Did you get cancelled yesterday?
Yes. They won't put us on another flight.
Have you been caught up in any of the cancellations, or what's the go?
Not at all. We came to Sydney, enjoyed a weekend with my brother, and yet nothing, absolutely nothing, no impact.
And keep in mind, it's the end of school holidays here in New South Wales. Plenty of parents and kids at the airport hoping that they'll be able to come back here to Sydney in time for class tomorrow.